Hey, what's up, everybody? Welcome back to another episode of the Bot Squad Podcast. We are at episode number 70. Stop laughing, John, because it just seems like I put it on, right? Like, I just, like...
No, it's just...
Anyway, if y'all don't know, I'm David, and this is...
John.
What are we drinking today, man?
We are... What we have already started drinking is another New Belgium beer. We've had plenty of them before. I think we had Snapshot, of course, Fat Tire... And I think we had one called Ranger, I think.
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah.
What about Ass Grabber?
No.
We haven't had Ass Grabber.
No. But I hear it's good. I hear it's really good. Here's another one. So the New Belgium beer isn't a stranger to us, man. So here's another one. And again, if you follow us on our other stuff, you get to see it, you know.
Yes. Right now, we're also streaming live, concurrently, I guess you could call it, on Instagram. Uh-huh. We're trying out the new Instagram live feature. So if you have Instagram, follow at Cinema Deviant, and we're live there. And during the pre-show, good buddy of ours, Tofi's Toys on Instagram, challenged John to chug one of these beers beforehand. Yeah. He took that challenge, and you succeeded.
I succeeded, man, but something happened.
With, like, some gassy pain.
Yeah. I mean, like, right at the end of the beer, it just, and then I got up and ran off, you know? And I didn't spew, you know? It stayed down.
He busted ass is what he did.
No, I did a mouth burp.
I heard,
it wasn't a butt burp.
It was a trumpet.
It was a mouth burp. No, I can't fart right now. But anyway, what we're having right now is a New Belgium gluten-y, but it's crafted to remove gluten.
Whatever. I mean, so, that kind of confuses me, though. Is it gluten-free, or is it, like, made to, like, burn gluten out of your system? You know what I mean?
Wouldn't that be like medicine?
Possibly.
This is the best medicine.
Let me take some.
Let's clear ourselves up, huh? All right. So, I haven't tasted a New Belgium beer that tastes like crap. No. And right since I already chugged that one. See, that's another thing, is I don't like chugging good beer. This is good beer, and it's good.
It is really good, actually.
What's the alcohol level? 6. All right. So basically 2%, a little higher than, like, you know, regular beer. It's still good. Real good.
Yeah, honestly, it tastes really good. It goes down smooth. Has a little bit of a bitterness right at the end.
Yeah.
But it's nothing that's, like, you know, overpowering.
And you know what? And it's a pale ale.
Hell yeah, Tofi just said he was going to have a shot with us right now.
All right.
So hell yeah, take that shot, man.
Hey, penguin.
You penguin fan. So anyway, let's go ahead and get right into it. We got a lot to talk about today.
Mm-hmm.
A lot. Some stuff that was left over from the last podcast that we didn't get to.
Yeah.
David,
we got to talk about this shit.
What?
About.
About.
About. What we missed last time.
You turned Canadian.
I saw that hosers, the younger yoga hosers.
Yoga hosers?
Yeah. And they enforced
what
the shit.
What you talking about?
Boot, yeah.
Oh, man, they were over-exaggerated with the boot.
Especially Americans, saying a boot.
Oh, I know.
Like, yeah. I bet if you had, like, a Canadian friend, they would probably try to, like,
smooth. They'd probably smack the crap out of you.
Yeah. I mean, don't you think they try to, like, smooth it a little bit?
Well, okay, it's just like people perceive us here in Texas.
Mm.
When people say, you know, oh, we say y'all, or hey, y'all ride, y'all ride horses to work.
To work.
God, get, no.
Fuck
like, no.
No.
Anyways, let's go ahead and jump right in. First order of business is they announced, a while back, they announced a Harley Quinn solo film. And Margot Robbie was executive producing and all that. She was streamlining it, wanting to get it done as soon as possible. And it looks like it's not going to be a solo film anymore, but it's going to be more of like a team-up film. And they're going to be going the route of Gotham City Sirens, which is interesting. I don't know if maybe they didn't feel like she was, you know, I guess, had enough star power, or maybe they felt like she couldn't handle a full film on our own. But, I mean, I kind of like this idea, though.
Me too. I think she has, her star power lies in the comics, not in the movie.
Not in the movie? See, I liked her in the movie, though. I liked her in Suicide Squad. The, like I've said before, I had just posted an unboxing video of all the Suicide Squad editions over on YouTube.com/CinemaDeviant.
How many
shameless plug.
How many of those?
Six. Six different versions. They're sitting right over there. Yeah. Anyway, I enjoyed the movie a lot. It was a fun movie. You know what I mean? Suicide Squad. But because, you know, you're coming off the heels of Batman v Superman, which was really dark and serious and
gritty.
Dark and gritty.
Dark and gritty.
And so when Suicide Squad hit, I just wanted to have a good time with it, you know? And it did that.
I still haven't seen it.
But there's things wrong with it. And I'm not going to say too much. Like, I accidentally spoiled a death in Fear of the Walking Dead with John a couple of episodes ago.
Yeah.
So I'm not going to say anything, but I do feel like, you know, maybe this is the route to go. You know, team up films, I think, are better for DC.
No, right now, especially for her. Oh, God. Like I said, okay, and this is just me. This is me. I'm hearing this from a lot of people. Reading their comments in groups and stuff like that, but she has a huge fan base, big fan base, being men and women, you know, but I see it more in the comic, you know, and putting her out there and by herself in a film, it would bring in, you know, but let's. Top it off with putting the other two in.
Yeah, I think that's perfect. Like you said, though, like, I think you can only go so far with Harley Quinn by herself. You know, you wouldn't want a whole movie based on her just pining over the Joker the whole time. You know what I mean? So I think adding Catwoman and Poison Ivy to the mix would be really cool.
And think about it.
I'd definitely go see that.
They've done it before in Batman Adventures.
In the cartoon and stuff.
You don't even take one episode.
See, and that's the thing, though, is that, you know, I'm sure that's probably why they did it, you know, is because of the success from that, you know, onward to the comics and all that stuff. It's like, you know, it hits. So, I'd definitely go see it. I mean, who do you think would be a good Catwoman in Poison Ivy?
Uma Thurman.
No!
As Catwoman. Shit, I don't know, man.
Look, okay, I think Jessica Chastain would be a good Poison Ivy.
Wait, who's Jessica Chastain?
Google her.
No. Is that the chick with the big teeth? The one that's in
No, she's a redhead, though.
She's a redhead, but she's that one that was... Remember that one movie with the dude from Workaholics and...
Hey, okay, Tofi said Penelope Cruz.
For who?
As who? Catwoman? I think she'd probably be a good Catwoman.
Penelope Cruz?
Yeah.
That's... She barely knows any English.
Okay, she'd have to take some dialect lessons. Hey,
but I'm not bagging on that because
you're being racist, John.
I love me some Penelope Cruz, man. Well, actually, her name is Penelope Cruz Tamez. She's married to me, but you know what I'm talking about?
As Cat. All right, he said as Catwoman, also. Fap woman.
All right. but what's her name? She's it's this one recent movie that came out with these two brothers. Apparently they're just so crazy and they do all this stupid shit. No. And they do all this stupid shit and they gotta find dates because their sister's getting married.
Mike and Dave.
Yeah.
Need
the chick with the big teeth. She came out in some singing shit.
Anna Kendrick?
Is that her? She was like in that
short,
that singing movie.
Yeah. Pitch Perfect.
Her.
Yeah. I think she'd be good.
Yeah.
You know, but she was actually rumored not too long ago to be Carrie Kelly, the female Robin.
When?
Yeah. She was kind of, you know.
Yeah.
Kind of wanting to go for it.
Yeah.
I don't know if that would work.
No.
But and she was also rumored to be Squirrel Girl and like, you know, she's going for a Squirrel Girl.
I seen
that. I think I could see Anna Kendrick.
I could.
I like her.
But as Catwoman,
the one with the big teeth.
she does have some big ass teeth, big gums and everything. She's like an alien.
I think that would be a pretty cool move though for Gotham City Sirens. I think I like the title. I like that they took that title from the comics and are applying it to, you know, a film.
Yeah.
It's just something about the title Gotham City Sirens just sounds cool. You know what I mean? Anyway, we're gonna go ahead and move on from that, and we'll talk a little bit about a mobile game. We don't really talk about mobile games very much.
We should. I'm on Clash of Clans.
Oh, screw that. But a mobile game that just dropped, actually yesterday.
Jerk.
Was... I'm sorry, John. But not everybody likes Clash of Clans.
I got the Simpsons.
So this game just dropped yesterday. And it's Super Mario Run. The anticipation for this game has been like just over the top, because, you know, it's the first mobile iOS, you know, Nintendo game.
Yeah.
They've never had a Nintendo game before, on mobile devices. So this is a big deal. All right. And, you know, I signed up for the alert whenever it went, you know.
Oh, you're going to get it?
Well, I already got it.
Wait. All right,
hear me out. Okay, you gotta listen.
Well, hold on, because okay, this is what I seen, and you please fill me in.
I think you're gonna go into what we're talking about.
The trailer.
Trailer.
That's what I was gonna talk about. The trailer.
Oh, go ahead, talk to her.
The trailer just showed a bunch of people running, like they showed like parkour and all. I was like, what is this?
I'm not Assassin's Creed.
I swear to God, man. Like everybody in that little trailer was on my phone. And it was just everybody parkouring, and I was like, "What is this? What's going on?"
My thing about it is, like I said, I signed up for the notifications when it went up and all that stuff, and I got notified, "Get Super Mario Run now!" And da da da. I was like, "Oh my god!" So I got them on my phone, in my electronic devices, and what have you,
and whatnot,
and I got on them, and I'm like, "Oh my god, I'm gonna download it," and you know, you go through a tutorial and all this stuff, and. And you finally, you know, start the stages. And basically, you're running the whole time. What you're doing is just basically jumping. You can play with one hand.
It's a constant run.
Yes.
Okay. So you're not pushing forward or anything.
No.
It's running.
So, look. No.
Like Flappy Bird. All you do is...
Basically, yeah. Okay. So, I mean, I was already prepared for that.
Uh-huh.
I was like, okay. So I'm playing it. I was like, man, this is kind of fun, man. And I'm over there playing it. And, you know, I get past level 1, level 2, level 3. And then it tells me, in order to continue, I need to purchase a whole game for $10. And look, $10 really isn't a lot. It's not. But, you know, honestly, all the stuff that I had heard about it going into it, maybe I didn't look into it enough.
Yeah.
But I didn't know that was the case. And basically, what they'll do is they'll let you trial run the next stage for 20 seconds. And that's it.
You know what that is? That's some hoe-ass shit right there.
That's some hoe-ass shit right there. Normally, I don't agree with you.
That is, man.
But that's some hoe-ass shit.
It is. You got sucked in, man.
Yeah, no, it's definitely like, you know, microtransactions, you know, and stuff like that. And it's like, okay, at least, like, blatantly say it.
Yeah.
You know, try the first three stages and then purchase it for $10.
Yeah. Demo.
What I was under the assumption was that you could play the whole game, like download the whole game, but it would be with ads. And then in order to, you know, take away the ads, then it would be the $10.
Like Clash of Clans
stop talking about Clash of Clans, John.
Or Pokemon Go, you know, it was free and stuff, you know.
Pokemon Go was good, was like cool for about like a week.
No, it wasn't.
2 weeks.
No. It's still cool. No.
It's not cool. I don't play it no more. Well, that means it's not cool.
You don't play it. You know, it's still going on, and then they just recently had that update with all the other Pokemon and stuff like that. But
which anyway. One?
The second download, it came with all the extra ones.
Which Pokemon?
I don't remember the second wave.
Damn you, John.
That's the one with the what's his? Ah, damn it. Something dial. It's a little crocodile one. Oh man, he's the water type one.
Oh, I know what you're talking about.
Yeah, him.
And it was a plant one.
Well, they all have that first series of just
and
like
the fire
one. You know.
I know. I'm messing with you.
Man.
Anyway, but yeah, so Super Mario Run, it was a bit of a disappointment.
Well, what did the graphics look like?
They look okay. That's the other thing.
Was it like 64 or like Wii U?
Wii U. It looks like Wii U graphics. Really? It looks nice. Yeah. I'm not gonna lie, and that's the big like you know attraction to it is that it looks really good and it plays really well. Everything is very fluid. There's no like you know lagging, no skipping or nothing like that. But it's just the you know it's just. Be straight.
Okay, so
with like, your marketing strategy.
Okay, so level one, you can kind of like get a picture of level one. Level one,
I'm Total Dial.
Total Dial.
Yeah. Like,
did they just shut up. They put a thank you, Total. Somebody already said it.
That's the water Pokemon.
That was Total Dial. Now say the green one and the little fire looking one with the pointy nose. I forget his name.
Whatever.
Anyways, but like okay, so you can already kind of tell that level one was what. Blue skies and green shit everywhere and everything, yeah. Right? So, what was level two? Like, was it the
do-do-do-do-do-do? Yeah.
Underground. Underground? Okay.
And then the third one was, like, up in the sky, like the where you have to step on the mushroom tops or whatever.
Okay, so then...
So, yeah.
They're just kind of going with the same shit that they
always go. Yeah, they're giving you a little taste of everything right in the beginning.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
And they're like, oh, purchase this for whatever. And I'm sure that there's going to be... other, you know, things that you have to buy.
Think about, like,
that. In between.
Remember, like, World 8 number 4 or whatever?
Chikorita is the other one. And Cyndaquil
Thank
is
you.
The other one. Thank you, man.
Chikorita is the earth one.
Yeah.
Yeah. Cyndaquil is the fire type.
Anyway, go ahead.
I've been drinking. But think about, like, remember, like, World 8 on NES. Super Mario Brothers on NES, World 8, Level 3 or 4, whatever it is. Before you get to the castle and everything, there's that one part. Remember with the brick wall in the back? And then you jump and you just land on just a little bitty box. There's a couple boxes.
Oh, yeah.
You know damn well that's coming up in one of them run stages.
Oh, yeah, I'm
sure. You
know
what I mean? Oh.
I'm sure. Okay, and let me go ahead and say here, Matt. 11708 on YouTube and said Kevin Smith's new movie sucks, by the way. Sorry if you guys liked it. It's not a great movie, I'm not gonna lie.
Hey, we didn't say that it didn't suck.
Yeah, yeah.
It was it was cheesy as hell, man. It really is. It's so different from all the other movies that he makes, but I don't know, man. It was totally different. I bit my lip, man.
It was totally left field.
Yeah,
hell of what he usually does.
Because the ball usually goes to the right field.
Now you can see his humor in there,
yeah.
But it's not anything like you know the CG effects. They sucked. Yeah. They did, but it was just to me it was entertaining. Just the fact that Kevin Smith made a movie that was just so weird and crazy.
He forced his daughter to be in it,
and Johnny Depp's daughter, and Johnny Depp. You didn't know that was Johnny Depp.
Wait, who?
The detective guy.
Oh, God. For real? The French guy?
Yes. That's Johnny Depp.
For real?
And the other Colleen in there is Johnny Depp's daughter.
That little skinny chick.
Yeah.
The one that knows all the languages
yes.
and shit. I didn't catch that. You know who I thought it was? I thought it was fucking, what's his name? Not Richard Grieco. But
Richard Grieco.
What's his name from the Breakfast Club? The badass.
Emilio Estevez?
No.
Judd Nelson.
Yeah. That's what I thought it was.
It was Johnny Depp.
God, man.
Anyway, we're gonna go ahead and move on from that.
It was okay.
And we're gonna talk a little bit about this is another topic that we meant to talk about the last time on the podcast.
Yeah.
And this is a topic that's close to my heart, man. Uh-oh. Close to my heart. Like, I could get wrapped up in this. I'm going to try not to. And it's God Particle. If you're on YouTube streaming it, you see a picture of Clover. That's all I could find. But they announced that this God Particle is basically going to be Cloverfield 3.
Yeah.
The third Cloverfield film in the series, anyway. So, I mean, that kind of has me excited. You know, just for the simple fact that during the viral marketing for 10 Cloverfield Lane, there was this there was a package, I guess you could say. They gave coordinates, and people like rushed out to go try to find this thing. And somebody posted a video. Honestly, I don't know if that was viral in itself or somebody actually posted it. You know what I mean?
Yeah, right.
It's kind of hard to tell. It kind the line starts to blur between that stuff nowadays. But this person found it in a field in Louisiana, dug it up, and there it was basically an ammunition box. Had various USBs in there and stuff like that. When he popped it in the computer, it had various audio files. This audio file sounded like it was from the International Space Station.
Mm-hmm.
And it was a couple of astronauts talking about how they, you know, they're there doing certain checks and stuff like that. And then they see a red light, like a big bright flash that completely blinds everybody.
Yeah.
And then they're like, oh my God, did you see that? It's like, yeah, what is that? I don't know. You know, and then the transmission kind of cuts off. And I was interested in that aspect already as it was, because I was like, what is this? You know, is this something about the Cloverfield monster or whatever coming down?
David suspected everything.
Dude.
Especially when those movies come out. I
love this stuff.
He's just all Inspector Gadget.
If you guys know us, if you guys have seen the podcast in the past, you guys know that we love speculating on things. We love speculation. We love theories. We love all this stuff because it's just so fun, you know, taking guesses and then sometimes most of the times being right.
Lately, actually all fucking year. So
yeah, you know, so when I heard that this supposed film was being announced called God Particle, and it was being produced by J.J. Abrams, everybody just like, what?
Yeah.
You know? So they started looking at it, and it's the synopsis of what they had there sounded exactly like the audio file, you know, that they had in that viral, in that USB thing.
Yeah.
And they finally confirmed it, though. They confirmed that that's what it is. This is going to be the third Cloverfield film in the series.
And it makes sense because in the movie, remember in the movie, they said there was a bright light.
Yeah,
remember
they did.
They meant what they mentioned. What David just mentioned in the movie,
the Howard dude, right?
Yeah. And the 10 Cloverfield Lane movie, they mentioned that stuff. You know what I mean? And I just really hope. I don't, because I kind of wanted to keep going, but I they need to tie this shit up.
Yeah,
it's kind of weird. Two movies, and then, you know,
what I think they'll do is they'll start tying little things here and there, and then they'll keep going.
You know.
Apparently, from what I hear, rumor has it that every year they want to put out a Cloverfield film.
Really?
Yes. So that's very ambitious, you know, for this to happen.
Yeah.
But what it seems like they're doing, and like what they did with 10 Cloverfield Lane, was that they took an existing script that somebody had wrote, and they just kind of tweaked it to make it into like a Cloverfield film. You know what I mean? So that's kind of smart. Because it's like, take what you have out there and then just change it just a little bit here and there, and then put your spin on it, and then there you have another Cloverfield movie every year.
All I know is that that shit leads here to Houston, because that chick, she was in Louisiana. She was not in Louisiana because of the fields, but she was nearby.
I think it was like close, like maybe borderline Louisiana, Texas or something.
Anyways, but then again, then you have this whole hunt for the, like the ammo box and stuff in Louisiana. So, but it leads here, man. It leads here. So
I would love to see a Houston-based Cloverfield film.
That's what I'm talking about.
That would be awesome. Right there. Like, sign me up for an extra.
Hey,
Boss Squad Pocket, we need to be like broadcasting this stuff, you know,
in the movie.
Yeah.
You know what, like I wonder what we were doing at the time when we get attacked, you know what I mean, like in
Independence, chugging gluten-free beer
Independence Day when they nuked us, like what were we doing, you know what I mean?
You'd probably be taking a dump.
Nah, that's not
Keep blasting off the toilet.
Nah. drinking a beer. Yeah, I mean, it's the end of the world. You know what I mean? But we're about to get nuked.
They've kind of released a little bit more information about the film, and it sounds very interesting to me. They have what it's called. I cannot remember. I had it in my head, and I can't remember now. But there's something out there, like a certain like a certain test that they do with like particles and atoms, and they kind of dubbed it the God particle.
Yeah.
And what these astronauts are doing basically is that they activate this God particle, and it releases this big old blast, which is probably that red,
yeah,
you know, blast that we heard about. And when they look out after the blast clears, the Earth is gone. And they're under the impression, and again, I say this very loosely, that they're under the impression that they destroyed Earth.
Yeah.
So they're freaking out.
Yeah.
On the International Space Station.
You got to think about it. If you're an astronaut in space and you look down and Earth is gone.
Yeah.
Like, what do you do?
So I don't know, man. I'm kind of. This sends me on a weird speculation quest because, okay, what if, you know, this happens, and again, they're looking at Earth. Next thing you know, they don't see Earth.
Yeah.
What if this like shot them somewhere else,
or
it, like an alternate dimension or a parallel dimension?
I thought about it.
You know,
I was thinking the same thing. Or they got turned around.
Yeah. Earth is just behind them. The whole time. We can't see it. Where is it?
The whole time's behind them, man. I mean, how can you turn around?
That's some bullshit Twilight Zone shit.
It right is. A scary door.
That's some whole ass shit. That would suck, man. If the whole time Earth is like behind, yeah, them, like directly, like, oh, we can't turn.
That would suck so much, but, man. Everybody paid money to go see it, and that's what happens.
But I really feel like we're looking at possibly like some sort of alternate dimension stuff here.
Do you remember at that time when they talked about that movie Gravity came out?
Yes.
And then like The Martian.
I love that movie. I love Gravity. I love The Martian too. Those
Martian
are great
was good
movies.
Yeah. And like, okay, so then let's say, you know, there's the blast, right? And then George Clooney and Sandra Bullock, it hits their International Space Station or whatever the hell, and then you just see like Sandra Bullock just like, you know,
You see George Clooney on there?
Yeah, both of them. You know, and they head straight to Austin. You know what I mean? Because
they just go Austin.
Shit, just catch on fire and just.
Whew. You just see them do like an anime pose, like straight down to Austin.
Yeah, and then, you know, and then
no.
When they impact, then the Earth blows up.
This is what they do. Look,
George Clooney, him and his big head.
Whatever, they go down, heading straight for Austin, like you said, right? Uh-huh. And they go.
No.
Team Rocket.
No. No, George Clooney, him and his big-ass ego, his head catches fire, and then when he strikes, he strikes like a huge-ass meteor, you know? He destroys Earth.
With his head?
With his head, yeah. Or his wiener, because he's always, you know, whatever.
You just totally ended it right there.
Yeah.
But, okay, we'll get back to this God particle. But speaking of Gravity, though, have you ever seen I think it's called the Diamond Lux Edition on Blu-ray? What they did basically is they took out all the music and they just left it
quiet. Really?
It is so eerie. Like, wait, it's the weirdest thing to watch.
Yeah,
but it's so nice, you know. It's strange because it almost feels like you're there. Watching it in 3D is one of those things where you're like, oh my god, like you're like in it.
Yeah.
Especially that movie. But then with no sound, it's like you're like hanging out with them in space where there's nothing at all.
Put that movie in that version on the Oculus. Or, you know,
I think I'd probably throw up on myself.
That'd be cool, man. That'd be cool as hell.
I'd probably throw up on myself.
When he mentioned that, the what came to mind was Memento. Remember how it had what, three different versions of the movie?
Yes.
So you can look at it at, you know, look at it at, you know,
the out of order, the right order, yeah, and then I think backwards or something like that. It's weird.
I've never seen any.
I've seen it. I've seen it the out of order, which is the regular way, Memento, and then I've seen it the chronological way where it's supposed to go. Where
that's what I want to see.
I saw it. I didn't like it. it wasn't enjoyable because you get everything within the first 3 minutes of the movie.
That's the only movie I like that guy in.
That's it. Great movie, though. Love it.
Yeah.
That's what made me really like Christopher Nolan as a director. But anyway, we want to move on from God Particle.
God Particle.
Because, again, I could go into it forever with this Cloverfield stuff.
Yes, you can.
And we will most likely... I keep...
Throw it to the back. Throw it to the back. It works.
I keep... anyway, so... I will most likely we'll come back to it on another podcast.
Oh God, yeah.
But anyway, so we're gonna go ahead and move on to some Power Rangers news. Power Rangers movie news at that. Now, okay, this has been a controversial type of thing.
Are you empty?
Almost. Controversial type of thing lately. Just because they've been showing more and more little by little,
yeah,
you know, of the movie and some of its characters and things like that. They've been releasing it little by little, and I always, you know, try to tell everybody when, especially like a movie like this that's touching on people's childhood,
yeah,
and you know, the stuff that they love. As collectors, I don't know, you can probably can't see up there.
No, you can barely see a little bit of it.
But, you know, it's a touchy thing because you want to get it just right.
Yeah.
Right? And they've been announcing these things and it hasn't really got the greatest reaction.
No.
Lately. And like I said, usually I tell everybody, you know, keep an open mind, wait till the movie comes out. Yeah, we saw the trailer, you know, but you can't really, you know, give your 100% decision, you know,
based on the movie. Go out there and get 110%.
You can't give your entire, you know, like, you know, mind.
Yeah.
I guess your decision on it.
Yeah.
You know, based on the trailer, and usually I'm very like, okay, give it a chance. I don't know now.
Well, okay, now
you know I'm being very honest, and it's like,
I know what you mean, but see. They did it in a way. It wasn't like they released another trailer. They didn't.
They've been releasing pictures.
Yeah, and like just information, just like telling you shit.
And it's kind of hard to really. I've tried to defend it.
Look. This is what David's going through. Like, if you're like a true Transformers, you know, like, you know, if you're a Transformers G1, you know, like fucking fan, and then what they did with the Transformers movie. All right. It's like, that's not what it's supposed to be. Laserbeak doesn't look like that, you know? And what's going on? And it's funny because how many... episode 70. We're episode 70 episodes, and you have not seen David stutter like this in 69 of them.
Yeah.
And so now episode 70, David's almost at a standstill.
Because it's hard for me to get out the words, you know what I mean? Because I'm serious, because I really, you know, Power Rangers is my thing, if you guys didn't know.
It's a jam.
Power Rangers are our thing.
It's a jam.
You know, we have been longtime fans and, you know, collectors and things like that. And I've, you know, kind of put my all behind, you know, this announcement of the movie and all this stuff. I'm like, man, it's going to be cool. They're going to make it good. They're going to learn from their mistakes. And I feel like they're going down that road of mistakes again.
Yeah,
you know, and you know, they showed the picture for Alpha, and I was not impressed. He has a look of him in a way,
but the stupid
he has little eyes on the corners.
Snell eyes. Like, what was the point of that?
And it's just really weird. Toofy here says, "So let's see a pudgy pig. I know the perfect casting for it. My ex."
Wait, what?
He had to do a double take.
A pudgy pig?
Pudgy pig, remember?
I thought he said putty.
No. Remember Pudgy Pig? Pudgy Pig. Basically, it was a pig face with little arms and legs.
It was the first monster that came across. Yeah, with the helmet. Yeah.
Yeah.
He ate everything.
So they announced, or they showed the Megazord, but it was kind of more of like a, just like an action figure type of, like a deluxe action figure Megazord. Wasn't impressed. We've gotten more photos of the, you know, of the actual individual Zords, not impressed. You know, I like the Tyrannosaurus. It, It reminds me a lot of Grimlock from Transformers.
Yeah. Yeah,
so I kind of don't mind it. The other ones, however, I have an issue with, mainly with the Mastodon.
Yeah.
And apparently they're making it a Mastodon spider hybrid, which is insane to me.
That's stupid.
Yeah, it'd be cool to have a spider Zord, like, you know, in another series.
Yeah.
But a Mastodon spider hybrid, it just doesn't make any sense to me. Yeah. It's two opposite ends of the spectrum, you know? And like John was showing me earlier, and I didn't really snap to it, was that the Mastodon is a leg.
Yeah.
In this one. Usually it's the arms. The Sabertooth Tiger is the crotch. Or like John likes to call torso. It a torso.
Yeah.
I just say it's a crotch.
So you just got like two fangs hanging down.
Two fangs, know? On the crotch.
It area. Does, because like the fucking head's right there, you know?
I mean, if it gets excited, just go, I don't know.
Bite the shit out of somebody.
But yeah, so I'm not impressed so far. They haven't shown Zordon yet.
No, they haven't, no.
They haven't. The only thing that to me is kind of cool is Rita. I actually have kind of grown on the way Rita looks.
Yeah, it don't bother me.
Yeah, it doesn't really bother. And I like Elizabeth Banks as an actress. She's a really good actress. But one thing that we... everybody, I should say, not just we, but everybody speculated on, was that when they showed promotional photos for her, she had her staff. But in her staff, right in the middle, was a little glow green.
Yeah.
And when you start looking at it, you know, against the other power coins that they have in Power Rangers, in this version of Power Rangers, it looks exactly the same.
It does.
Now they've come out and actually confirmed it, that is a power coin in her staff, and, mind you, that she used to be a Power Ranger. The Green Ranger.
Yeah.
You know, at that. You know, I probably not the exact look of the Green Ranger, but a Green Ranger.
What if instead of like the gold vest, if it was like a gold skirt?
Gold skirt.
Yeah, you know.
Probably. With anyway.
The diamond in the front.
Diamond around the crotch. You and crotches, man. Yeah. Come on.
Yeah. Oh, I mean, come on. She's pretty hot, you know.
But so, the other like interesting thing that they announced, and it kind of, again, makes me feel weird about it all, is that, you know, with that, they said that basically Rita is going to be going after Goldar.
Yeah.
And looking for Goldar. But it's not the Goldar
that we think
it is.
Yeah.
Or the Goldar that we remember. He's not like a monkey with wings type of thing. Yeah. More of a bioweapon. Which is weird to me. You know, it's more of like a biological warfare type of thing. Is it like some sort of disease that's going on? And when Zordon, you know, imprisoned or blasted away Goldar, he basically spread out across the earth, spreading his gold particles.
So
every, not Rita, god particles, gold particles.
So technically Rita's looking for gold.
Yeah,
and when David says that Zordon, they mentioned that Zordon as a teenager was basically
a Power Ranger.
Yeah,
you know,
weird. So new, I guess. So we get to see what Zordon looked like.
I would hope.
So then there would show. Yeah, right. That would be. I think it'd be pretty cool. At least.
I just want to see Bryan Cranston in a Power Ranger uniform.
Or no. Or they put Bryan Cranston like on a young him. They make him.
I am the one who knocks.
Say my name.
You're damn right.
Stupid. What if he transformed? What if he morphed? And he had the fucking hat. It just like, you know.
The Heisenberg hat.
The Heisenberg hat. And then like,
hey, they gave the Ninja Steel, the Gold Ranger Ninja Steel guy.
Oh, the hamburger guy.
The cowboy hat, yeah. So I don't know. So it just seems really strange that they're making Goldar not an actual, from what we know anyway, what it seems like, not an actual person, or a being, more of like a you know, an essence, I guess. And from what I hear, she even robs a bank. to go after gold.
To get gold.
To get Goldar back, whatever. But the interesting part, and I'll say interesting loosely because it intrigues me, but I don't know how to feel about it.
It's crazy.
Is that they're going to be, you know, basically the whole point to this movie is that Rita Repulsa is going after the Zeo Crystal. Zeo Crystal, if you guys know, Power Rangers Zeo, is one main crystal separated into five different shafts.
Hey, don't you think that's kind of... It's crazy.
Yeah.
It's crazy because it's so early for a movie. I mean...
Chris Christie as Zordon.
What?
Anyway. So
it's crazy. I mean, to talk about the Zeo...
I think what they're doing is building. Because from what I hear, that they're trying to make this a big franchise.
Really?
So, I don't know how far they're going to get, though, with them going down this route
so far. If they fuck up.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And, you know, it's ambitious. And, you know, I kind of like the idea that they're introducing the Zeo Crystal so soon. And maybe, like, hold off on, you know, them activating it. You know, until maybe another movie or like maybe a third movie or something like that.
How would they incorporate the fucking the Zeo logos into the outfits?
Well, I think they'd be new outfits. I think it'd be completely
They wouldn't put a star. Yeah. They wouldn't put two lines. It'd be some dumb shit. It'd be like a real star. You know, just like burning and shit, and you know,
be the Super Mario star. But you know, I don't know. Again, I want to get behind it. I really, really do. But it's getting very hard to. And, you know, they intrigued me with the Zeo Crystal thing. Zeo Crystal thing. But I don't know how they're going to be able to really, you know.
So technically,
put it in there.
Rita answers to somebody. Yes. All right? Because she's doing somebody's, you know, fucking. Somebody's bitch. Go get those damn Zeo
pretty much.
So what happens? So she's trying to get these Zeo crystals.
Well, yeah,
or no.
Basically what had happened originally was that
in the show.
No. In this version of the movie,
oh, okay,
is that Lord Zedd was the main guy going after the Zeo crystal eventually. I like the fact that they're including him.
Yeah.
I really like the fact
that he's the head honcho type. That's pretty cool.
Yeah, and he's like basically the mastermind of all this. But what I don't like is that what they basically said, that he tried to go after the Zeo Crystal and he got burned by it. And they burned half of his face, which basically just sounds like Two-Face.
It does. And you know what?
Like a Two-Face thing.
And
not like the whole inside out type of, or skin showing Hellraiser-y type of.
That's so cool, man. What was the Cenobite? Cenobites.
Yeah. Cenobites.
But you know, so then you know what's gonna happen, right? They're gonna get some damn a human being that's like burned, you know, or you know, singed. The reason why the dude's burned is because nobody's allowed in the I've already forgot the name of the damn
Command center.
The command centers. I forgot. Nobody's allowed in there unless you have a power coin, you know, which I don't see why.
Yeah.
You just can't walk in there. But so apparently, apparently, Lord Zedd, dumbass, didn't know that he couldn't just walk in there, and he tried to, you know, so that's how he ended up getting his face all scarred up.
Yeah, so I'm wondering if they're going to really, like, show Lord Zedd, you know, or maybe they're going to end it with him, like, all of his skin getting ripped off. I don't know. I hope so. That'd be kind of cool. That'd be really dark. That'd be really dark, but that'd be kind of cool.
If they laser beamed his ass and he just, you know, and it just, everything just melts off.
But yeah, so, so there's, you know, there's a lot to really, I guess, take into consideration for with the Power Rangers movie. What do you think about it so far, though? Like, as a whole, as all the, you know, with all the news that we've been hearing and stuff like that.
Okay, it was going great. Like David mentioned, I mean, like, you know, we talked about it and everything. Everything seemed great, you know? I mean, like, everything was going to be, maybe not up to par, like, how we know, you know, and love the Power Rangers. But we just, we saw it as, you know, like, that, you know, okay, well, this is a new beginning to something good, you know, something awesome. But then all of a sudden, and what blows my mind is that, you know, because they released this information not in, in a trailer. It was just like, hey, you know, telling people, you know, just like, just throwing it out there on the internet, yeah, and on the intros nets and everything. And it's just, at least, I don't know. Don't you think that I expected a trailer for that?
Exactly. Or, I think so too.
Okay, now what if they do show us in trailer form and it just even blows even more? You know, just like,
yeah,
it's a letdown. To me, it's a setup for a letdown. You know,
I don't know. I just hope that they, again, I'm still gonna go see it.
Yeah,
I'm not gonna lie.
Oh, because like,
but.
Because like when you, because if we're like the first ones there, they give you power coins and stuff.
Yeah, probably. Yeah, most yeah. likely.
And think about the Cubs, man.
Oh my God, the Cubs. Oh my God, the Cubs. The commemorative stuff, the collector stuff. Oh my God.
Oh man.
But okay, so good. So Lahan 91 on YouTube over here has said, "I grew up watching Power Rangers, but I think they should put this to rest because they can no longer do it right, movie or TV." TV.
All right, hold up.
Look, TV is always going to be there. They're always going to make the shows, cheesy or not. You know, kids like them. You know, I think I've gotten accustomed to the idea that the Power Rangers show is not for me anymore.
Yes.
As an adult.
Yes.
You know what I mean? They're for kids. So if I'm watching them, I'm watching them just because, you know, I'm interested in seeing, like, the new Zord or, you know, things like that as a collector.
Yeah.
And things like that. You know, my son loves Power Rangers still.
Yeah.
And he'll watch every season so far.
What's his name?
Lahan? You know, I don't know if... the TV show is not going to end. I highly doubt it. It's gone on for 20-something years already.
Yeah.
Like, maybe 22 already at this point.
I thought they were 25 already.
No, they're like 20... Maybe about 22, maybe 23.
Okay.
But, yeah, so they've gone on that long. They're not going to end the TV show anytime soon. It's a moneymaker. It's a toy, you know, it's a toy deal. They're making money off of toys. Movie-wise, if this doesn't go right the way they want it to, I don't see another Power Ranger movie happening after this.
No.
You know, they're trying to set up a franchise. It's not gonna go well if this doesn't happen well.
Lahan. This is what it took me a while, dude. It took me a while, but I kind of finally came to my senses. Is that, you know, yes, you know, it's not, you know, to us, I guess, because if you grew up same period that me and David did, yeah, it's not the same. So
we're old.
Yeah, we're old. so we're looking at it at a different angle, like, because we want it to be like the MMPR, you know what I mean? Yeah. And it's not, but apparently it's still hitting home and it's still making the money and everything because it's hitting home on a different, and you know what, and this is where I saw it, because once Time Force ended, you could see
it's kind of where it dropped off.
It did, yeah. And you could see that's like the other the levels and there's the ages and even like Jason Font. And then when they talk about, like, their fans, you can hear them are like, oh, well, it's, like, this generation of people or whatever. Well, yeah,
because Time Force, honestly, Time Force is kind of where I dropped off, too. I think I watched SPD after that for a little bit.
I couldn't.
And I didn't watch the whole thing. But Time Force was one of those seasons that was the most dramatic
out of all of them. Because of the Red Ranger and the Pink Ranger.
Yeah. And they had like a drama filled storyline going on. It was like, what?
They were already married, right? Or they were about to get married, right? And then he died.
What? Oh yeah, in the beginning, characters.
Beginning the characters.
Yeah. I think they were involved or whatever. And then the guy died, and then she goes back in time and sees like a duplicate of him.
Yeah.
Or a doppelganger, basically.
Something like that.
Yeah. So I mean, that season to me was the greatest, as far as dramatic.
Yeah.
You know, I think I was getting a little older at that point, but I was like, what? This is kind of crazy.
Yeah.
But I was like, low key, still like a Power Ranger. I didn't want nobody to know.
still rocking the wrist communicators.
Yeah. But right now, as an adult, I'm like, man, I don't care. I love Power Rangers.
Man, I know, dude.
I love toys. I love everything.
I, you know,
fucking
yeah, if it transforms, I'm buying it, man. Especially right now. And you know what? And again, no, the series are not getting bad, because you know what, dude? I didn't believe David when David told me about what was it? The Super Samurai?
Yeah. Well, I started getting into Super Sentai, which is the Japanese stuff. The Japanese stuff is a little deeper, a little darker.
Yeah.
At times too, a lot more dramatic, for the most part, and it can get kind of silly too.
Yeah.
But it's some of the greatest stuff out there, especially the toys. The toy aspect of the Super Sentai, probably the best I've seen. And, you know, whenever it gets...
compared to the American...
Yeah, whenever it gets sent over here to America and they start making the American version, you get spoiled very easily.
You do, man.
You know? And it's like, oh my God, am I going to pay, like, $20 less for something that's, like, smaller and has a lot less paint on it?
More plastic, yeah.
Yeah.
Less detail.
It's like, I'd rather just get the Japanese stuff.
Yeah.
So I've been a big fan of the Japanese, you know, Super Sentai and the toys and all that stuff for a very long time. And I always said when Ninja, you know, hit...
What's going on with that?
When Ninja hit in Japan, the moment I saw it, I was like, this is going to be the next American one that we see. And of course, that's what Ninja Steel became.
They changed the outfits.
No, they didn't.
With the black, with the black on the arms.
Oh, you know what? A little bit. I think they did a little bit.
They're silver.
They changed it just a slight bit, not much though. The toys, however, you know, they're about the same size, but there's obviously a lot of missing paint on it. Like, they didn't paint a lot of things, yeah. And Bandai has been I don't mean to, you know, talk bad about Bandai, but you know, with the Japanese ones, you have the main Megazord, the main Zord, and then you have the individual things that you can put in the middle.
In the inside, yeah.
That you could buy separately for like $20 or something like that.
Yeah.
Well, these, you have to buy a completely new Megazord for each one. You know what I mean? So, it's a cash grab. Yeah. It is. Tofi right here just said exactly, you know, what we feel like. Imported toys are the best.
Hell yeah, man.
You know, most of the time that is, you know, that's right on the nail, or nail on the head, I should say.
Yeah.
Yeah. So we're gonna go ahead and move on from that. I know, I know you're sad.
There's a little bit more. A lot. Whatever.
Okay. What do you want to talk about?
No.
He's like, well. let me step up to the mic here.
No, but let's move on. Because yeah, like David says, we can just continue.
Yeah,
on
we could, shit. And there's a lot.
Hell yeah.
We're gonna go ahead and move on to The Walking Dead. Walking Dead just had its mid-season finale for season 7, and it was you know, kind of crazy. It wasn't what I expected. I thought it was gonna be a bloodbath. You know what I mean?
And beyond.
But, you know, it... Okay. Reset. It was great.
It was.
I loved the mid-season finale. I really did.
Mm-hmm.
It wasn't what I thought it was going to be, though. Again, let me switch it up. Because it was sounding negative right off the bat.
Yeah, and I was like,
yeah, no.
What's going on, David?
No. What we started out with was Negan shaving in the mirror. And he has this smile on the whole time. And it was so just like, I love this guy, but I hate this guy. All at the same time. You know, the same sentiment that I guess that we've been kind of saying the whole time.
Yeah.
You know, this guy's such a charismatic guy. You love to hate him. And, you know, that was one of the scenes that everybody had been waiting for a very long time.
For the shave. You know what? And as soon as he did it, I was like,
exactly. I was gonna ask you that too. How did you feel about that?
I wanted his beer back.
I think, you know what, it just didn't make him seem so mean anymore. I don't know.
Mm-hmm.
I think the beard looked good on him.
Well, just like what he said about Rick, he goes, that Rick right there.
Oh. This dude's like my dad. I love him, but I hate him.
but like Negan said, you know, yeah. He was like, I wouldn't have you know, fucked with that guy with that beard.
Yeah.
You
know. See, and it kind of shows the same thing. Like, you know, kind of with the beard is like, it kind of made him a little bit more menacing. It, with the beard, makes me a little bit more menacing.
Oh, yeah.
My voice got deeper all of a sudden. Stupid. I don't know. But the funny thing, this was, and not many people, you know, I guess, I watched it with, you know, family or whatever.
Yeah.
The living room. I was the only one that let out this big old, like, laugh when this happened. Was that next scene, they show Carl and Judith looking at him while he's shaving. But look at Judith's face. It's like, look at this motherfucker right here.
Oh, wow.
Like, she has, like, mad dog face on her. And I thought that was hilarious.
A little ass kicker?
Yeah, for real. Like, honestly, that's kind of the first thing I thought of when Daryl, you know, gave her that nickname or whatever. And, you know, again, that made me laugh, like, out loud, literally. So I was like, okay, cool. And then, you know, we see Rick and Aaron, you know, heading out on that boat that we saw in the last episode. And a boat full of bullet holes, mind you.
A little jumbo.
And they're heading out over that little lake.
Yeah.
To that, what was it? Like a river boat type of thing?
Yeah, it's a, oh, what is it called? Yeah, it's like, remember there was the little sign that said, if you can make it to my little hideout, then, you know, there was food and shit.
It's like one of those things, like, you made it this far, you know, I have, you know, shotgun, or I have this and this and this and that, you know.
So they
so proceed if you will, kind of thing.
They bit the bullet and they tried.
And they, I don't know if I would have done that.
I would have.
In a boat that had a bunch of bullet holes, well, that you were going to sink?
No, but if you're watching,
you're taking up water.
Look at it. The fucking boat is on the other side. Why don't they just walk around?
Well, you see, they could have done that as well.
Yeah, it wasn't like the boat was in the middle of the water.
Take the hard way.
Yeah, it, like a video game. It's like left, all the dark and scary shit, or like right where the fucking rainbow and the deers are, you know, prancing around.
Toby again says, "Perfect casting for Negan." He's so much of the comedian in his acting from Watchmen.
Dude, the guy doesn't even... He just... just shit comes out, man.
Dude, the way that he just portrays the character is... You know, he'll say a line and just smile, and it's like, you son of a bitch.
Yeah.
You
know? Yeah.
You know, it's just so, like...
And
man.
He does it so damn good, man. And it matches his character because...
Monica C... on YouTube, which is my wife, mind you, says, I personally like them without the facial hair, which she likes me without the facial hair, so that's why you said that comment.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Monica,
she's been bugging me to shave, like, completely.
Then what happened?
I don't want to shave. Completely.
Okay.
Anyway. It's funny, so... And, he's out on the raft, and they, you know, head out to this boat. The whole episode is very back and forth.
It is.
Between characters, and it's a good thing, because, you know, you get a lot of story.
It was an hour and a half, right?
Yeah, it was an hour and a half.
Yeah, yeah.
They didn't announce it that it was going to be an hour and a half, but they did, but they made it an hour and a half. And then you go back to, you know, Alexandria, where... Negan is there with Olivia, which is the girl that is in charge of the food rations, and Carl and Judith, and he made them spaghetti.
Yeah, and he was like, try this.
And basically he says, you know, you're going to have to set another plate because, you know, we're going to wait for your dad, kind of thing. It gets to this point, and they're there sitting at the table, just kind of sitting there, twiddling their thumbs, and he's like, you know what? I'm not going to wait anymore. Mm-mm. I don't know where the hell your dad is, but we're going to, you know, Lucille's hungry is what he said. He got the bat, put it on the chair.
I thought he was going to tear her up.
Yeah. And he goes, Carl, can you pass the rolls? And then Carl doesn't move. Please? And then he gives that smile. It's like, oh, okay, here.
Did you see him on what's that chick? That Kelly chick? That Kelly Ripa,
he did. Yeah, I caught a slight glimpse of him, and he was like the co-host, right?
Yeah, and he was cool, man. He was cool as shit.
He is such a nice guy, dude.
He is
such a nice guy. And again, that's kind of one of those things like you just want to hate him so bad, but then you know how he is in real life, and he just seems so cool as hell.
Too cool that his son gave him a scare, you know, and like he said that his because the dude has a farm, you know, the guy has a farm, yeah. Like cows, chickens, and fucking goats and stuff, and
fucking goats,
and
fucking goats.
No, that's a breed of goats. There's like goats, the fucking goats. And then there's fucking goats. You know what I mean? and so he says that he ran into his son and he asked his son, "What are you doing?" And he goes, "I was playing with the chickens, Dad." And he goes, "What were you doing?" And he goes, "Well, I had Lucille with me."
Yeah.
And then he goes, "And I was telling the chickens, you know, eeny, meeny, miny." He goes, "Oh my God, you know."
Are you serious, really?
Yeah. He goes, "You didn't just," and he took off running. And he ran into the chicken coop. He was like, "Please, hilarious." Yeah, because he was thinking. He goes,
"That was so funny."
And because he said his son loves Negan, which is, you know, him, Dad, you know. Oh, and so he runs into the chicken coop. He's like, "Man, I'm expecting blood and guts and shit." He goes, "And the chickens are all fine and everything." And he came back and goes, "What happened? What were you thinking? What was going on?" He goes, "I was, you know, any, mini, miny, mo." You see it, you know, yeah. That's his dad, man. But this kid is looking up to, not dad,
the character.
Looking up to, yeah, Negan, you know?
Pull out Lucille. You gotta bring out Lucille. We're talking about The Walking Dead.
It's Christmas.
We gotta bring out Lucille. So they, you know, the episode continues with one of the guys from the kingdom. I can't remember his name. And he, you know, approaches
Sean.
Morgan?
No.
That's all. Man. He presses Morgan and Carol trying to, you know, basically convince them to go to war. You know, to get prepared to go to war.
I wait.
And, yeah, so, I mean, again, we get to see more of the, you know, I guess, more of them getting ready.
Yeah.
You know, more narrative of them leading into all-out war, which is going to be a big deal. Oh. Excuse me. I don't know if they're gonna do all-out war in the second half of the season.
I don't think so.
Or if they're going to do it, like, fully in season 8. I think maybe the second half of this season is going to be March to war, where they start, you know, preparing everything.
Getting everything together.
And then by the end of this season, you'll see, like, you know, we're going to war.
Quarrel. But I mean, you, at the end of this one, man, it was cool, man. It was cool. After all the BS. And,
3D. Sorry. Anyway.
What's his name? Getting gutted? That's in the comics, man.
We're getting to that, John.
Oh, okay.
Getting to that.
Okay.
Spoiler.
I have been drinking.
What we find next is Rick and Aaron, son of a shit, Rick and Aaron finding guns on that boat. And then they have they find like a paper. It says, "Congrats for winning, but you still lose." Now, I was kind of like, I didn't know how to take that. I was like, is there going to be some sort of like booby trap?
That's what I thought too.
You know?
That's what I was thinking.
When they leave?
I thought like it was going to blow up or something.
Or is he just talking as a whole? Like, okay, you found the guns, but it's still going to be of no use to you.
Well, there was no ammo.
You know, yeah.
There was guns, but no ammo.
So, and then right after that, we see a pair of mysterious boots, like on the shore, like looking at him. Now, these boots are important to me because they look very tattered. Look very tattered, like they're not new, and what it seems like is that the guy or person, I should say, I'm not gonna say guy because it could be a woman, that the person actually replaced shoelaces with electrical cord, like electrical wire, and wrapped it around, you know, the ankle area and stuff like that. And the only thing I can speculate about that is that you're out in the woods. You know, there's bugs, ticks, whatever. You know, all sorts of things. Yeah. You don't want them to get in your pants. Smart, very smart. But you're looking, you know, I'm looking at it as this is somebody that's like salvaging things from places.
Yeah.
You know, maybe somebody's not like completely established. And they're looking at, you know, Rick and Aaron. It for all we know, it could be the owner of this boat.
Yeah. That's why it means
you still
lose.
It could be that. Don't know for sure though. And we don't really get a good look at that either. But it's again an interesting thing to speculate about again.
Mm-hmm.
Like I thought maybe it could be Jesus at some point, or maybe even Dwight.
I thought the same thing, the Jesus thing. I thought the same
but
thing.
But why would they like make Jesus mysterious?
I don't know. They
it's,
made
it's funny what I'm saying. Why would they make Jesus mysterious?
Jesus is mysterious, dude. You
but
know?
You know, it's like I thought it could be Dwight as well, like trying to kind of walk in the shadows, kind of following everybody, because in the comic, spoiler alert, he is a traitor, you know, to Negan's camp eventually. But yeah, so and then they end up showing Spencer. He's first he was bloody or whatever from his little misadventure that he had. And then they show him getting ready and getting off,
speaking of traitors. Yeah.
Getting all spruced up and stuff like that, and getting all handsome and everything. The guy's a handsome guy. I'm not gonna lie, but I will say that was a negative thing for him. Handsome never flies on The Walking Dead.
No, it's like you've been redshirted.
Pretty much.
Yeah.
Thank you for saying that. Yeah. I love that term. Anyway,
yeah, it's a pretty good one.
But yeah, they show him getting ready. And then they show little snippets of like Daryl escaping. They had Daryl escaping the whole
man. I was
Negan compound
when I saw the motorcycles. I saw his and I was
knew
like,
"You were gonna say that."
And I was like, "No, get
I
that
knew
one."
You were gonna say that. And then from there, we see little Joey getting Negan'd. He got Negan'd. He got bashed in the head.
Oh, little Joey, man!
that was his name, little Joey. That's what they called him.
That dude got hit in the head with a pipe, man.
So he got Negan'd basically. Yeah. And then, you know, from there, we get Spencer, you know, confronting Negan whenever, you know, he basically wants to talk to Negan. Becoming friends, having drinks, and he's telling him, you know, about the community, how he can make things better and stuff like that.
I'm just like my mom.
Yeah, basically.
Queer.
And, and you know, we get a lot of, again, this was already leading up. You know, we saw a lot of this lead up to it. And how Spencer was feeling about Rick, and it, again, if you're a reader of the comics, you know what was coming up, and I knew what was coming up, but I was like, well, they could spin it a different way.
That's what I thought,
you know. And so, you know, he's talking to Negan. They're playing pool together, and then he starts telling Negan about, you know, his plan that, you know, Rick's no good. Da da da. He's like, oh, so basically what you're trying to say is you're trying to take over.
Yeah.
You know, well, why didn't you kill Rick yourself and just take over?
See, that's what I thought. I thought he was gonna like, you know, like grab him and grab Rick and, you know, kind of, I mean, like go at it. That's what I thought.
Well,
that's when we, like when you said the spin or whatever.
Yeah,
that's what I was thinking. Here goes the twist, you know.
Well, I know. And well, here, this baby Lucille. baby Lucille. without the barbed wire, anyway. I've had this bat for a very long time.
Lucy?
Yeah. Lucy and Lucille, yeah, exactly. So I thought it was going to go a different way. It went exactly the way it did in the comics. Where he's like, you know, Negan walks up to him and, you know, starts telling him, you know, he's like, the thing is, you know, Rick does these things, and he basically protects. I'm not saying word for word, but he basically protects, you know, the people here.
Yeah.
So what you're trying to do is just, you know,
take over somebody that's not around here.
And then he's like, you know what? What's wrong with you is you have no guts. And then he guts him. He basically sticks him with a big old Rambo knife.
Bowie knife, yeah.
And just guts him, like guts spill out to the floor. You see Spencer just grabbing his guts. And
I didn't know in the comic, because I knew this happened in the comic, but I didn't know in the comic that was Spencer.
Yeah,
I was like, yeah. You know, so when it happened to Spencer, I was like,
okay, and again, I knew it was coming, but I was kind of, in a way, I was kind of hoping it would have been a little different. Not saying that, you know, I'm not happy with it. It was kind of a cool moment.
Hell yeah.
You know? And then Rosita gets very just like very aggressive, and just, she just, you know, she pulls out a gun.
Pew.
And basically just, you know, shoots Lucille.
Lucy.
You know, there's a bullet in Lucille, and Negan flips the hell out.
Yeah.
The words, and I quote, "What the shit?" You know, and he just starts freaking out.
Yeah.
You know, and I literally thought at that moment that Rosita was gonna get it. I thought Rosita was gonna just get the bat. You know, and it seems a lot like Negan is giving a lot of patience. You know, he's like giving them a lot of patience, a lot of chances. Because what did he say in the beginning? You know, you do this again, da, 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 you shut that shit down, you know, no second chances, yeah, type of thing. And he proved it right there. Now, with this case that somebody actually took a shot at him,
yeah,
he didn't, you know, he didn't shoot Rosita, but he commanded one of his others to go ahead and shoot somebody.
Yeah.
And Olivia got shot. Street Fighter noise. and I'm not gonna lie. I'm not gonna lie, but
Hold on, man.
That's stupid. I saw it coming.
Yeah.
You know?
She was too.
Because they were giving her a little bit too much story.
Yeah.
She was getting in the story a little too much. Mm-hmm. A person that was like mainly a background character.
Yeah, all of a sudden, know? She's in the limelight. Yeah.
So I was like, come on now. She got to take the bullet, you know?
She bit the bullet, dude.
Yeah. But yeah, so from there, you know, again, you know, Rick is just like mortified by it all because he's seen all this, you know, carnage, just him barely getting home.
Yeah.
And
his boy was getting his ass whooped in the gate.
Yeah,
you know?
Aaron.
Yeah,
just because of a misunderstanding.
Man, come on, man. Okay, are you gonna sit there and take an ass whooping? Are you gonna sit there and explain to yourself the dude's gonna? I found this equipment here. That damn sign was inside the box.
Yeah.
I'm cleared. I get to walk and go.
Yeah,
you know.
But even if he would explain it, they probably were gonna kick his ass anyway.
Man, muff that.
But anyway,
it's
so,
on, man.
So you know, Rick is kind of at his point right now at this point, and he's you know horrified by it all, and at the same time he's fed up.
Yeah,
you know, so you know, surprisingly they take a trip to the hilltop, and they have the long-awaited reunion with Maggie.
Did you notice how they kept having her wear the damn hat?
Oh
like,
yeah,
like
Glenn's yeah, hat. You know, and honestly, Glenn didn't really wear it too much.
No, not
in the
that
show.
One.
He wore it a lot in the comics.
Yeah, in the comic, yeah.
Yeah, so that was kind of a nice, like, little, you know, nod to the comics, I guess.
Remember me, Simba.
Anyway, and then on top of that, you know, we had the bromance moment with Daryl and Rick. And I'm not going to lie, it was kind of emotional because, you know, Daryl's been through a lot. He kind of had been
ate
tortured.
Dog food, man.
He's been on Easy Street. So yeah, so I mean, it was a big moment, and Daryl even gave Rick back his gun.
Python.
Yeah, and I was like, what? Like, you actually found that? You know, when he picked it up off of
Little Joey.
Joey,
yeah.
I didn't realize that's what it was. I just thought it was a random gun.
Me too. I didn't catch that part.
Yeah, and then, you know, when he gave it to Rick, I'm like, oh my God. Like, it was his gun. I'm sure Rick was like, I love you, man. I love you more, man.
Goddamn. You know? This stupid gun keeps following me everywhere.
It does. And it's a highlight moment. You know, it's a milestone thing for him. So I think that was really cool that they did that as well. You know, they did have an after credit scene to the show. I don't know if you saw that.
I did.
And it had to do with the guy, you know, or the person, I should
say.
The
boot.
A boot. I don't know what that was, a boot.
The dude in the boot.
But, you know, this guy was...
This Doc
Martens. I keep saying guy.
Doc Martens.
This person was spying on them with binoculars and stuff like that. We still can't tell who it is. To me, it seems like a girl. By the hands.
All right. I don't know. But two times, what you just said right now kind of makes me, I think you do know.
I don't.
Don't lie to me, David.
I don't. And right. And I'm, trust me, I'm still thinking about it, but I don't know for sure. And,
David.
Okay, I'm sorry.
Don't lie to me.
I'm sorry. Sorry.
I think you do know.
It's not PP Pan City, okay? I'm sorry.
I think you know.
I don't.
Because you go, I don't know why I keep saying him. And then you go.
Well, no, and I keep saying him just out of reflex because I keep wanting to think it's a guy, I guess. But it's not. I don't know for sure. And it could be a girl. All
right.
There's also the aspect that could be one of the whisperers. I don't know at some point. Whisperers are the people that wear the skin.
The skin.
Now,
yeah.
There's one thing that I did want to add.
Weird.
It has nothing to do with the finale. But the episode with Tara and Heath.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay. You know, at the end of that episode, she found a key card.
She did?
When she went to go look for Heath after she came back to the bridge.
Uh-huh.
She was leaving. She saw Heath's glasses busted.
Yeah.
And, like, tire tracks, whatever. Uh-huh. She found a key card, and it said PPP on it.
Uh-huh.
Now, yeah, I didn't really snap to it at first, but I'd seen a couple of other videos, relating to this point, and I was like, oh my god, like this kind of is pretty cool, is that you see PPP, you don't really think of anything, but when you look at that as far as in a musical aspect, PPP is like the, I don't want to say musical note, but it means like whispering, so that could be like the first like little Easter egg, you know, towards that. They probably won't even build on it until next season.
Yeah.
But it could be like the little, just little inkling, you know, for the Whisperers, you know, coming forward. So that's pretty cool. I actually didn't think about that. And when I saw that, I was like, all right, that's kind of a neat little add on there.
That is pretty cool.
So, yeah. On that note, we're going to go ahead and end this episode of the Bot Squad podcast. We've wasted enough of your time.
People. Nah, man, we've given you some shit here.
And this was a very good episode. Thank you guys for watching over on YouTube, if you guys are streaming it there. And on Instagram, for the first time, Instagram Live. Thank you guys for watching. Everybody that's joined in. If you guys are, you know, watching on Instagram Live, it will be going on our YouTube page, youtube.com/CinemaDeviant. You can check the full video out there. Actually, right away after we're done, it'll be up for replay. So you can check it out there. Keep visiting cinemadeviant.com for all your movies, news, reviews, trailers. Facebook.com/cinemadeviant. Twitter @cinemadeviant. Instagram cinemadeviant. Snapchat cinemadeviant. Tumblr.com/cinemadeviant. And whatnot. You know what? Just Google cinemadeviant.
Everything
will come up. And what are your social medias, man?
Bobby94 on Snapchat and Instagram. No, on Twitter. And Spawn94AEW on Instagram, and it's been getting real good.
Yeah,
it's been getting a lot of good, real good, you know.
Yeah,
and
so.
Like David said on Facebook, man, we got 100% on communication there. So as soon as you guys put something in, it, and you know, we're on top of it.
Yeah,
you know?
So keep liking that page over there as well. Share it if you can. You know, it was much appreciated.
Oh yeah.
Hit that subscribe button on YouTube as well.
Yeah, we're just like,
that's definitely much appreciated.
Beat
as well.
The fuck out of it,
beat
man.
The fuck out of it.
You see it, man.
And on that note.